Hi, this is my 2001 Mitsubishi Shogun. It's the 3.5 litre V6 and it's the long wheelbase version, 7-seater. As you can see, the paintwork's in really, really nice condition. I'll show you briefly. This is a well looked after vehicle. It's got the LED light bar. Hidden under there, it's really good for winter conditions. As you can see, the reflections in the paintwork are excellent. I look after this vehicle really well, and you can see just in how good condition it is. I didn't get a valeter to clean this, this is just how I keep the vehicle. You can see wheels in very good condition, and actually, we'll mention that the tyres I put on these Yokohama. I'm a Geolander ATS. I only bought 1,000 miles on those at the most, maybe less. And you can see how nice the plastic under there is, underneath, and how straight the bodywork is as well. One or two tiny dings here and there, but this is a 16, 17 year old vehicle. These Road Ventures on the back. We're probably about 80% wear left on those, and these are on / off-road tyres, same as the front. Again, wheels are in really good condition, and you can see underneath, if I can just, yeah, there you go, there's no rust on this. I have really looked after this. When I bought the car, it wasn't undersealed, so I undersealed it, but I checked the rust first, and again, you can see how nice the condition of that is. It's got the spoiler on from the factory. There are only a couple of marks really are here. It's a bit of a scuff mark. And sort of this area. It's got the tow bar with electrics. I haven't used it for towing though. And the main rear. Main bit really is here. Well, it's obviously backed into something, and here, but really that's just cosmetic. It's plastic as well. The only rust on the car anywhere is, in fact, I don't even think it's well, it's not really rust, it's that. Again, down this side, just really, really straight. Okay, you can see no massive dings. There's one tiny one on the door, which I'll show you. Wheels again in excellent condition, and I'll show you actually how you open the door under here. It's just obviously mud again. It wasn't undersealed when I bought it. I checked it all, checked it for rust, and undersealed it myself. The only thing is here, but you know, you can see that's just me being fussy, and there you can see that one. That's it. Apart from that, very straight, and again, you can see how nice the plastics are with just a tiny bit of wear there. It's to be expected on a vehicle of this age. Again, the wheel here is in nice condition. Like I say, the front tyres I replaced about 1,000 miles ago, and these are ATS, they're really good in winter, and summer, good mix. So yeah, as you can see, just in great condition under there. Just that's just muck. You can see the suspension there. I've got photographs of the underneath of the vehicle, and it is in really good condition. It's not fully undersealed deliberately, so you can see that it's not rusty, because it's easy to hide rust with underseal. Okay, I'll go and show you the inside now. So this is the Elegance model. It's got, actually I'll show you from the other side where the sun isn't. And actually I'll go through these there, so you can see on the door cards, sorry, the doors, there's no rust under there, how clean they are. And no rust there, very, very clean. And again, on the front, I'll do this for all the doors, no rust on this. I've replaced these underneath with LEDs just so you can see them better. No rust, the only wear is this, where people have got in and out. But that's again cosmetic. The door's shut with a really nice heavy clunk, always a good sign. And you see this, the wheel cover is in excellent condition. I had this recovered, so it looks nicer. See, the chrome is in perfect condition pretty much. And again, you can see no rust and no rust under there. So yeah, the chrome is well, was obviously, it's not it's just mottled, but it's not rusty. All the edges are as well, there's no rust, that's just leaves. The only bit of the car I've got to clean. as you can see around here as well. It's in really, really fantastic condition. Boot has actually still got the toolkit in here. There you go, I'll just put that in to stop it from rattling. Doors moving away. These are headrests for rear seats, which I'll show you in a minute. So again, around the door frames, really nice condition. Again, just that's just wear from where people have, you know, opened and shut the door over the years. You can see no rust. I love how heavily these doors shut. It's a sign of Mitsubishi quality. Again, no rust. This paint's beautiful, it's really, really nice. The only area is here, a bit of a wear area, again, cosmetic. Could literally just be sprayed with blue paint, which I'm sure you can buy from a spray shop. Okay, let's go on the interior now. So it's an elegance model. So it's got full leather seats, and they're in really nice condition considering the age. They're not cracked, that's just cosmetic again. They've not lost any of the firmness of the seats. Well, the sort of bounciness are in really nice condition. All the plastics are really nice as well. And you've got the fake wood trim here. Actually, it looks pretty good. And again, the driver's seat is in lovely condition. It has got a sunroof. I'll show you that working in a minute. Sorry, guys. All the headrests, you can actually push these back as well for more comfort. Fold them forward. Glove box, that's just the locking wheel nut. Great, you can actually put coffee and stuff on here. And that's the owner's manual in there. And just a front pop-off bit, which when people were stealing stereos when they thought they were aware of something, that actually just pops off the front here. Quite funny, really. But I've actually replaced the gear stick with the wooden one off the slightly newer model, and also the steering wheel as well, just makes it look a bit nicer. So you can see the carpets are super clean. I don't smoke. Just really clean underneath there, and obviously on the edges. You've got the under armrest storage, and this actually slides forward as well. So these seats are heated as well, they do work. Again, you can see the doors, how nice they are. It's full electric windows all around. Okay, so again, the rear seats are in really nice condition, as are the carpets. A bit of dirt has escaped my viewing. So you can see there's no watermarks or anything on the carpets. I've got a spare reg plate for the towing. And you can see you've got rear heating for the car as well. That works, I'll show you that. Armrest has got cup holders on. Pretty funky little feature. You just lift that up and you can put your cups in there. And obviously just folds back up. These seats do fold all the way, and they fold forward as well. So you just pull that. That's obviously just so you can you pull this lever, and that's so you can get a bit more comfort. Put that back again. and these seats do fold all the way down and up again. I can't do that one-handed, but if you can see the car, I'll show you that. Okay, so this is a seven-seater, obviously, and these seats are really good condition. They don't really look like they've ever been sat in. You obviously remove this cover here, and that's another rare thing. You never get the boot cover. This one has it. So these are in really nice condition, and the headrests are here. They actually still there, really clever to keep them all the way. And the reason for that is that this seat actually folds. You can see the condition of the boot. Again, really nice condition. So all you do is just up once and another one. All you do is you just lift this boot cover all the way. You can do this one-handed. And all you do is you pull this here, this folds up, and then literally it's like that, and down, and one-handed, excellent appearance. So as you can see, it's in really nice condition. All the tie-down points are nice. There's drinks holders for the passengers, a little stowage place there. And you've got vents here for the third row to keep them cool or warm. I've actually darkened the back windows just to keep it cooler because I have a dog. As you can see, there's no dog hairs anywhere. I had a cover for that, and it doesn't smell in here either. So, just shut that. Okay, again, I'll just show you the passenger side under here. You see how nice the carpets are in, the condition they're in. And again, all the levers work for the folding of the seats. You can actually, if you're thinking of travelling, you can make this into a bed. What you do is, a lot of people don't know this, you just fold these front seats backwards up to this point. You fold these backwards, and it creates a bed. And again, I'll show you that if you look at the car. So the final one, obviously the driver side's always going to get the most wear, but again, no cracks, just it's sort of cosmetic. Again, in really nice condition, the bolster's absolutely fine on it. And the only tear in the leather is here, which is quite simple to repair. You can get a repair kit for about £20. The seat works. So, and you can see the condition again under this driver's side mat, which is usually in horrendous condition, especially on four-wheel drives, but you can see how nice it is under here. Again, these are the original Mitsubishi mats. And you can see all the buttons and stuff are in really good condition. I've installed a reverse camera, which is really handy for this size of this vehicle. So what I'm going to do is now, I'm going to show you underneath the bonnet before I start the engine. So excuse me while I just get this up. It's a very heavy bonnet. Alright, I'm back. Sorry about that, guys, it's really heavy. So again, you can see how nice the condition of this is. It's very dry under there. There's no leaks at all. Got this cold at the minute. It's not had anything done aftermarket wise. Yep, totally cold, as you can see. I'll just put my hand there. But that's just to show you it's starting. So yeah, you can see how nice the condition again of this is. It's been really well looked after, especially by myself. Battery's not very old either, I replaced that battery not long ago. So we'll go and start it up, and I will show you just how well this thing starts. Again, this is if you've not driven a petrol one of these before, they are excellent engines. Okay, I'll show them. It ticks over beautifully, no warning lights whatsoever. That's just the handbrake, obviously. 87,500 miles. It's got the four-wheel drive works. It's got I've just left it in four-wheel drive to show you that the lights are on, to show you how that works. You shouldn't really put it in and then just leave it, but it's got four high centre diff lock and four low centre diff lock. And this model actually has the rear diff lock on it. That's for the electric aerial and heated seats, high on low mode. They obviously both work, and you can hear the engine rev starting. So it's got a rear differential lock on this as well, which makes it super capable off-road. Everything works on here apart from the air conditioning. That, I know everyone says this, but it does just need a regas. The light comes on when you press it. Where is it? I can't see in this light. But the only thing is, these always get pixelated. I just replace that with a clock. You can actually see your miles per gallon, etc. there as well. And stereo all works. I've not tuned it yet, because I use mostly my iPhone. Maker. I woke up and I'm a little dizzy. Reverse camera, again I installed this myself, just put it in reverse, and there you go, super clear, really nice little camera there, and it really does help. This one's got a Sigma alarm system, really high quality one, and yeah, so let's actually show you the sunroof opening. There you go, it's a massive sunroof, it's more like a panoramic roof than anything, just a one-touch system. Again, back again. It sometimes stops just before there, it's like an accident prevention thing. And then also, just opens like that. And then you can just slide this back, and that's it. So again, in excellent condition. A lot of people don't know these are here. These are to stop the light coming in, and obviously when you put them on the side, you can do the same again. That's the same on both sides. See all the lights are working. I replaced these with LED bulbs. Literally, you can sit in the car and, you know, if you've sat somewhere and you can read with the lights on at night. And so, let's go and show you the engine. I'm not going to rev it yet, because I want to show you how nice it sits over. There's no rattling, no tapping or anything. It's been very well looked after. It's hardly got those miles. You can just go to the... gasoline direct injection motor. You can just go to the, if you want to verify the mileage, just go to the Vauxhall website and look up the MOT history, and that will show you the mileage. So you can see it's just getting warm already. If you just listen to the outside, there's no... Very good engine, see, 3.5 litres. Powerful and torquey, and really do motor along when you want them to. So I'll show you it going into drive, reverse, etc. And it's got the Triptronic gearbox on it as well. So you just slide that across and then up for upper gear and down for down a gear. And it's a super smooth gearbox. Right, things I've done to this to service it. The engine oil, gearbox oil, obviously the filters along with it. The gearbox filter was done, which is unusual, people don't usually do these. I've done the centre differential, I've done the rear differential oil, I've replaced some of the brakes, it's got the new tyres on, it's had a full huge service on it, and the cam belt and water pump doesn't need doing. I've got the paperwork for that as well. I didn't have that done, but it was done before I bought it. So you can just see how nice a condition this is in. I've got a driving video as well if you need that. But it's just a superb vehicle, and it's one of the better ones out there as well. And for the price, you're getting a really, really nice vehicle. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Any questions at all, guys, just feel free to ask me. Give me a call. And there is one more thing, actually. This has got the cruise control, and electric mirrors, which all work, as you can see. Same on the other side. Front and rear fogs, and obviously got the windows up and down the road. And there is one more thing I'd like to show you. I installed this button here, and that is for the super bright light up front, which I will show you. I don't know whether I'll be able to show it actually. We'll look right in a minute, but it's absolutely blinding at night, but it's low down, and everything electric works on our lights. You know, there's nothing electric that doesn't work apart from the air conditioning. So again, any questions, guys, please